Welcome to UroChannel. I know that this is not a topic that will be popular with my usual audience, but the advice I'm going to give you could be life-saving, because I know that the algorithm is going to show this video to men age 65 and older first, and you are the ones it concerns the most. My name is Stefan Buntrock, and I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist. Urology is a surgical specialty which, in my experience, the public usually is not aware of. Major abdominal surgery involving the intestines for plastic reconstruction is part of everyday urological life in hospitals. The bigger the operation, the greater the risk for perioperative DVT. DVT means deep vein thrombosis. It is a life-threatening condition which most patients take far too lightly. They usually say, "I walk around a lot, so I will be fine," which is a bit too careless, because surgery means major stress to the body. In addition to that, immobilization is part of the deal, so if you don't move because of postoperative pain, you will be at risk for blood clots forming in the deep veins, usually in the deep veins of the legs. This can also happen in healthy people, but the risk is no more than 90 to 130 out of 100,000 people. These numbers change dramatically once people get operated. It depends on the type of surgery, but in urology, 0.1% suddenly turn into 15 to 40%. The risk will be higher depending on individual risk factors: former DVT, being obese, being over 60 years, chronic heart disease, and infectious diseases will increase individual personal risk. Why is DVT life-threatening? Because these blood clots can start to move with the bloodstream. When this happens, they arrive at the heart, where they are redirected into the lungs. But the blood vessels of the lungs are far too tiny for those clots, so they get stuck. This is what we call pulmonary embolism. Blood will not be oxygenated in the lungs anymore, and the organs are no longer supplied with enough oxygen and nutrients. The heart will have to work more, actually a whole lot more. If this happens in multiple areas of the lungs at once, acute heart failure could be the consequence. The symptoms of pulmonary embolism can be rather subtle at first. Breathing will be more difficult, you start to cough, you get dizzy, the heart begins to beat quickly. If you don't know about this, or if your doctor doesn't think about it, your life is in danger, because this is an emergency that requires immediate diagnosis and treatment. The problem is, it can happen several weeks after surgery, so nobody thinks about this anymore. Everything's fine, the wound has healed, the pain is gone, you even walk around a lot, you feel great. But still, boom. I've seen it happen several times, and I have to tell you that I prefer a quiet life without any drama at work. So, what's the magic trick to make everyone's life a little easier? It's low molecular weight heparin. There are many different substances, indications, and contraindications. I won't go into detail here, because in pregnant women and patients already on anticoagulants, the rules are a bit different. Bottom line is, 7 days is minimum, but in cancer patients, it should be 4 weeks, especially if they are overweight and of advanced age. So, if you have to undergo surgery yourself, or your friends or relatives, be attentive concerning any kind of postoperative malaise that can't easily be explained. Because, as I said, catastrophe may be just around the corner. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.